Because I see on the movies all the time.
I love bikes.
You do. I used to. I used to.
You do?
I was a Harley Davidson freak.
I've got three.
I had also for 40 years. Then I broke both arms.
Oy.
A very bad fall. And then I just gave them up.
It happened to me on Hard Target, the movie I did.
Yeah, I know.
And it's very dangerous. I don't know about the city. It's dangerous because with the traffic and everything. I like to do some biking on the ocean.
Sure.
On the Pacific Coast Highway.
Yeah, the second fall, in 40 years,
right.
I had no problem. Then I had two falls in 2 months. And the second one was terrible. On a highway, a big hole, and I had surgery and all that. So
it's very...
I had to give up the motorcycles. I had, of course, a Harley, a fat boy, of course.
But Harley, with a sport bike, you slide more. Yeah. Harley, it's very dangerous.
Yeah.
It's a heavy bike, and it is dangerous.
It's beautiful.
I don't want my kids to drive a bike.
Yeah, sure. Don't let them.
No, don't let them.
And what about Brazil? I know that you're going away and that you want to come back.
Yes.
And it was the first time that you came to Brazil.
First time in Brazil, and it's a fantastic country. The people are so warm and they're always happy. And something nice about Brazil, I told newspapers, but when I came the first day in Rio, they told me, Brazil, it's fantastic. People are very sensual, exotic. Mm-hmm. So I go to the airport and I go, ding, ding. And I go, ding, ding. Vasco, escapa mais vala, Brazilia.
Wow.
Like you go in Germany, you know.
Fantastic. I imagine in Germany it must be a little different.
Yeah, it's you want to get out of it.
And Xuxa, you've been with Xuxa.
Xuxa?
Yeah.
Hi, Xuxa. How are you?
Xuxa. Hey, Xuxa. Yeah. You met Xuxa.
She's wonderful.
She's a nice girl.
She has lots of animals.
Yeah, she does.
Monkeys, dogs, ducks, horses.
Yeah. But she's still single.
Yes.
That's a problem. You're married now, right?
Yes.
Yeah. How many times have you been married, Jean-Claude?
Four times.
Four times?
Yeah.
It's a nice thing to be married, right? No,
bad
come
boy.
On.
Yeah.
Why bad boy? Why?
Yeah, I mean, nice. Love has levels. And you fall in love and you think it's the best, and then you have another level. And I'm learning about love.
We know we have a great poet already deceased, Vinicius de Moraes, who says love must be eternal,
right,
while it lasts.
Exactly.
So if you're married four times and now you are happily married.
Yes.
Is your wife with you in Brazil?
Are you crazy?
No. She's not here. I can assure you that this show will not be seen in the United States.
It's impossible.
No, it won't.
They told me you're all over the world.
No, it's not true. So you can tell us, did you find any Brazilian girlfriend just as a sort of a picnic?
Publicist? What should I do? There are so many beautiful girls in Brazil. It's like, look at that. It's like,
yeah.
And also beautiful
that's
guys.
That's an ugly guy over here. Oh, look at that.
They're beautiful people. But the girls should be very happy in this country because also the guys are very handsome. So it's a beautiful mixture.
Yeah, it is. And what about the other? Action actors, do you know them personally? Which ones are your friends, which ones are not?
They all like me, but I'm the youngest, so I'm like a baby to them.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they're like close to 50, I'm 35, so I'm like, I'm the young one, but they're all good people. I mean, they want to see if we have problems together. I think we all help each other. And for example, Arnold is a very funny guy, love life.
Yeah.
Sly is very sensitive. Steven Seagal is very boring.
Steven Seagal. He's what?
Boring.
He looks boring, but he has a fantastic wife.
Yes.
He's
divorced,
not married.
No, yeah.
They are divorced.
Yeah.
She did well. I think she did well.
You think so?
Yeah, yeah.
But they all have something very special.
How did he get that beautiful woman? Do you know? But
because he's got a certain look. He's got that macho.
Looks like that.
Yeah.
He looks like he's playing the trumpet all the time.
Hey.
And how can a guy do fighting movies when he walks? When he walks, Steven Seagal, ele tem boca de trompetista, né? And he walks like that all the time.
Yeah, yeah,
okay. He looks more like Charlot, like Chaplin than a fighter. And you tell me, he...
More like this.
That's it.
And Sly. And this is Sly. Stallone.
Hey, Jean-Claude, how you doing? How you looking great, man? You're going to go to it.
Man, you know Arnold. This is Arnold.
All right, Brazil.
You're having fun, you're sure.
Do just a little more Stallone.
I can do Jerry Lewis.
Jerry Lewis, okay.
Okay, but then I'm going to lose all my fans.
Nah.
I don't know, they don't like comical people in Brazil, no?
That's no, come on.
Okay.
You're kidding.
Okay.
Jerry Lewis.
Right? Right?
So, when are you doing...
No.
He's laughing. Look at that. Everybody's laughing.
Okay.
When are you always laughing.
He's on salary.
When are you doing your first comedy?
I don't know. Later.
Yeah, but I think.
You should.
I think you should. I think it would be nice.
And maybe we can do something together.
Wow, that would be fantastic. Of course. Tell me something. How do you work now? Do you produce your own pictures?
You see, it's like...
Do you have a I'm sorry.
No, sorry.
Besides the salary, do you have a participation on the film?
Not. You have two ways to go. If you produce, you're going to be so involved with all the numbers and all
sure.
the booking and the location. I direct one film. It was a headache because I care for the movie like a baby.
Yeah.
It's better to be in a studio, to have a great producer, and you can really concentrate on your acting.
Yeah.
Your lines and let professional people like
do
a
rest.
Good producer, director, and
yeah.
I'm a movie star, and that's it. You know,
yeah.
I think it's better.
And about what I asked, that very inconvenient question about salary. You have a salary, and you have also a part of the movie.
Yeah, I've got a good salary.
You're a partner of the movie, let's say.
Yeah, so. But if you need like a special definition called gross point from first dollar. Because
mm-hmm.
if you have a successful movie, no matter how much the movie is making, they're going to charge all the bad
that.
Movies to your movie.
I know that.
So you have to make a special deal with them. But sometimes studios, if they spend more money in a good script and a very expensive director, you can go low on your salary and to have a great career. And that's what I'm fighting for.
Yeah, and that's I think that's the good thing because
yeah.
We see and we think about so many great actors that didn't have any part on their success.
Right.
And I think it's not right. I think it's.
Yeah, but I mean, also studio. They take chances.
Uh-huh.
War is frigo. They take chance on putting money, investing
mm-hmm.
money in the project, the script, and everything. So, it's.
Has to
it's
be 50, a deal. 50,
yeah,
yeah. 50,
yeah.
50.
It's relationship. Movies, it's about relationships.
Fantastic.
With
well,
directors and everything.
When is Sudden Death starting in Brazil? When começa? It's starting now. Está começando.
But I've got a gift from my friend. I've got the T-shirt of the big penguin, the one who was fighting with me in the kitchen.
Tem presente para mim? Cadê ela?
Sim. Por favor.
Ah.
So that's for you. And you can use that as a pyjama.
Fantastic.
Please.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, gente. Eu conversei com essa simpatia que é o Jean-Claude Van Damme, e você nota, conversando com Jean-Claude Van Damme, que ninguém faz sucesso impunemente. Jean-Claude, thank you very much for being here with us. Daqui a pouco a gente volta. Melo Soares, pela sua presença aqui conosco. E nós vamos terminar o programa com uma canja muito especial do Morten Harket, que é vocalista do grupo norueguês A-ha, tá? Tá no Brasil para divulgar o seu primeiro CD solo, Wild Seed, que tá ali, ok? Wild Seed. A todos vocês aqui, muito obrigado. A vocês em casa, muitíssimo obrigado.
E eu agradeço também.
Boa noite, Cristel. Muito obrigado.
My band, it'll be just the guitar and me. Kind of Christmas card. All you folks back home, I never tell you this. Not supposed to know where your daughter is. There are ways of life that you never understood. Right here, downtown Hollywood. It's afternoon at Sunset Boulevard. I got a stolen moment, trying hard to write a kind of Christmas card. And I'm burning out again tonight. Guess there's really nothing much to say. See, this place is as dirty as I feel myself. There are still some riches at the Roosevelt. That evening prayer, those memories in my little bedroom, mama on my knees. That's where I'm at, down in Los Angeles. The girl I used to be. She was my age, once mama, 23. I can still hear some of the songs she used to say from my summer of love in 68. Seems turned into a winter of hate. Never tell you this. not supposed to know where your daughter is. There are ways of life you never understood. It's right here, downtown Hollywood. It's afternoon at Sunset Boulevard. I got a stolen moment trying hard to write a kind of Christmas card. And I